Happy Monday. Today's Motivational Monday is entitled, You Are What You Think. So I'm sure you've heard the saying, you are what you think. But do you realize that you may not be what you think you are? The great philosopher James Allen wrote, as a man thinks, so he is. As he continues to think, so he remains. And author Earl Nightingale said, we become what we think about. Roman Emperor Marcus Aurelius wrote, a man's life is what his thoughts make of it. Those great minds found the key to living an abundant, happy, and purposeful life. Our thoughts. The quality of our lives reflect the quality of our thoughts. But due to the lack of the understanding of our thoughts, when we're unhappy in life, we tend to change things that are external factors. For example, we may shop, travel, eat, etc. to find happiness. The issue with this method is that we accuse external factors for our unhappiness instead of going to the true root of the problem, our personal thoughts. In other words, if you want to change the outside factors, you first have to change from the inside. Change your thoughts, change your world. I know it sounds easier said than done, but you can do it. Simply make yourself aware of the emotions that each of your thoughts bring. If those thoughts bring positive emotions, they help cultivate your happiness. However, if they bring negative emotions, they contribute to your unhappiness. Simply put, the emotions that your thoughts provoke affect how you feel, and how you feel affects how your body reacts. And how your body reacts directly affects how you behave. And how you behave defines your character, who you are, and what you experience in life. So this means that our problems are not truly our problems. The real problem is how we think about our problems. In other words, we are not our circumstances, but we are what we think about our circumstances. And if you think you're a failure, you'll feel like a failure and you'll start to act like a failure. But thankfully, the opposite is also true. If you think you're successful, you'll feel like a success. And then you'll start to act like a successful person. So basically, your past thoughts have been contributing to your thought pattern, and your thought pattern is what's creating your reality. The best part is that you have the power to change your thoughts. Each time you notice a strong and negative emotion, pause and ask yourself one or all three of these questions. Why am I so sad? Why am I so angry? Why do I feel so down? These questions will help you get to the cause of those feelings. And once you address the cause, it's time to derail those thoughts that cause those feelings. So here's my list of favorite ways to address negative thoughts. First, accept things for what they are and without adding or accepting any negative opinions. Second, replace negative opinions with neutral, positive opinions. Third, stop talking about a situation when you notice that your words are causing negative emotions. And last but not least, fourth, create a positive saying for all of the negative sayings you use and say those instead. Now, remember that you are not necessarily your thoughts, but you are the thoughts that you give power to, and your thoughts create the reality that you live in. So, choose the reality you want to live in. Now, this week's challenge, practice doing the four activities that I've just told you about, and listen to this daily, and write down or say one or more things that you can do to redirect your thoughts. And I also suggest reading one of my favorite books that has helped me understand the power that my thoughts have over my life. And it's called As a Man Thinketh by James Allen. And that's it for today. And thanks for watching. And until next time, I hope that the rest of your day is peaceful, positive, and productive.